Hello peeps. As per request by Naughty Pell, I'm going to show you now the Gaucho interweave, the 10-part 8-byte Gaucho interweave into the 5-part 4-byte Turk set with a loop as shown, both as shown by Tom Hall in his unpublished drawings. And as in the other one, I asked Tom Hall for his permission to do the video of this one. And he graciously agreed. And as the numbers already indicate, the 10-part 8-byte is a kind of Gaucho fanot. In this case, it's not going over one under one and one side, but it's going over three under three. And the regular Gaucho cannot be tied with two ends, obviously, as the interweave is an unfinished Turk set and would have three bytes in this case, and you cannot tie three bytes with two working ends. You would have need to add an even number of bytes. So let's start. We go over the standing part and then go into the knot by going under 2, and we stay above the one we're following. So we do the same thing that the one originally does. This one goes over here, under, over, and we do the same movements with the new chord. The same with the next one, go over the standing part, go under 2, do the same thing as we have done before, we follow this one, go over, under, over. So, and now comes the peculiarity of the Gaucho fanot. We stayed over the one we are following when we went from left to right, and now we change direction. We stay under the one we are following, and we came out over, and now we go in under. And we're following the one that is above us, so we're doing the same. This one goes over, so we go over, and then comes the new knot, the new chord. So this makes a pair with this one. So we have to split the pair in this way, that we go over this and over this one, so that we come out the way that we already, that we can do the under that we have to do here. So you always orientate on your old chord, what the chord before did. And here already we go out over 3. The next one is the same movement. We go in under 1, follow the chord that lies above us, so we do what the chord does, we go over, this is already the new one and this is the old one, so we have to go over here and under here, and so to split the pair we have to go over this. And we go out over 3. And here we take, we already see we have some pair going on. So we go in under, we come out over, we go in under, split the pair. And we are orientating towards the cord that lies below us. And this here is the new one, so we did what the cord did here. We went under this one, but this is the new one, so we split the pair this way. And we have to go over this. And the next one, this is the old one. So we go, we split the pair here, we go over this, we go over this, and then we go under the old one and out over the two. So this one was the new one, and we had to go over this. And we had, of course, to go over this because this is the old one. So, here again, we come out over three. Turn this round a bit. We see the pair, and we're following the one that is below us. Do the same and do the opposite thing to the new cord, which then follows. And again, do the same to the old cord. Go over these two, and this is the old cord too. So we go under. And we go over, out over two. So now we go back. And now there's not much to see. We have really recognizable pairs. And we must fulfill this over two under two pattern. So we go under two. Over two. Splitting pairs. And out. Over three. Same here with this one. We go in, a bit fumbly here with the camera, under two, and then split pairs again by going over two and under two. And go out over three. We do not count the standing part, we are just counting the cords inside. And now we're going to remove the cork and just finish the knot by going inside. So we go over three, and then we could simply go out here. The same going on here. So now we would just have to tighten up the knot, but as you can see, this is the gaucho knot, and of course this is on top of its head, because really if we tied this as a knot with one cord in the regular way, we would have this over three, or in the other case we would have gone over one and all together in the left side and the middle, the over two under two. So this is the knot tied from the correct direction, but as I find it's always a bit enlightening to try something else. It makes you more get used to the patterns and understand the patterns better, and so here it is, the 10-part 8-byte gaucho as drawn by Tom Hall. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.